Well, hey there, welcome. I'm Shauna, and you have stumbled upon Witchcraft Now.
Oh my God, I'm so glad you're here. I have to tell you about this deck. This deck isn't due to release until July 8th on Amazon, and I found it on magic.com, M-A-G-I-C-K, and I'm going to leave a link below, and I have a code you can use. It has nothing to do with Amazon or anything like that. They just have like an affiliate program that I signed up for, and I'm super stoked because you guys get to save $5. I get $5. It's a win-win for everybody. You can sign up for it, and the same thing can go for you. But this deck, I purchased with the intent of using it for like in my magical practice or doing research into the gods and goddesses and just finding out more about each one, basically. I had no idea that I was actually going to be able to use it as an oracle. I thought that it was going to be something a little different than what it has turned out to be. I mean, I knew it had keywords on it and stuff. And I got it because Ra and Bastet are in here. Okay, let's just face facts here. Bastet is my goddess, and I am a huge believer of the Law of One. And if you don't know what that is, I will leave links, a couple of links down below in the description for you to check out, because it's so profound. Aaron Abke is a wonderful teacher on the Law of One, and Pamela Mace has the series where she's playing the books, and she has downloads about it, and she talks about it before and after each section of the books, and it's so, so good. Okay, just seriously, the Law of One is everything. It's just everything, literally. We're all one. So, but here's the book, and the book descriptions have everything numbered, super simple, right? Here's the book, all the book you get. All the rest of this is in different languages. So the book, unfortunately, isn't as chunky as it looks. But you get enough to kind of get a basic comprehension of what's going on, plus your keyword, right? And there are spreads back here. There's a pyramid spread, an existence method spread, and a relationship method spread. I haven't used any of these yet because I got a couple of decks on the same day. This was one of them. The last one I'm going to show you is another. And the second one I'm going to show you is actually another that I got with that order as well. But I was surprised to see how many decks actually go with this, because this is such an unusual type thing, right? I mean, it's ancient Egyptian hieroglyphs. Like, how many decks can possibly go with this that you have lying around, right? Oh, but wait and see. We're going to start out with the Smith-Waite Borderless, because that's the one that I have. That's the one I chose when I first started several years ago, and it just is. It just goes. Do you see this? We have two very recognizable symbolic decks that you can recognize for what they are. You know, you have the OG Tarot with this ancient Egyptian glory right here, and it just is beautiful. They just marry wonderfully. And I haven't read with these two decks yet, but that's coming. The one that I have been reading with, we will get to that one because it shook me. I was very, very surprised by that one. I was equally as surprised by this one, the Tarot Muha, because we're looking at some Art Nouveau here next to this. You wouldn't think, right? I only set it next to one another because the colors were similar, But it's so beautiful. There's something about this time frame of the Art Nouveau era that just goes so well with this deck. It looks like it's just trying to have a baby. It's beautiful. It's just absolutely beautiful. I mean, in this deck right here, we're going to go through some of the cards. They are just astounding. It's light and dark together. This is the perfect deck for shadow work. That's what I have been using it for. And I have had some profound messages come through that just blew my mind away. All right. The third deck we're going to look at with it is the Intuitive Night Goddess. I got this in one of my boxes a few months ago. And look at this. We just have these starry nights next to this papyrus. And it's gorgeous. It's just simply gorgeous. These remind me of UFOs floating around. I love it. And here we have planets. You know, I mean, there's so much symbology in both of these decks, in all of these decks. The symbology is unbelievable. It's just undeniable. I mean, and you can agree or not, you can use whatever decks you prefer with it, but I was really shocked to see how well just the decks that I had laying out on my desk went with this. This is something that is so, has such a particular style that I just simply wasn't expecting it. The least one that I expected is this one right here. I've edged this one in like a honey brown and made it like kind of a patina, but it's the Deviant Moon. This is the one I've been using with this deck for my shadow work and spirit work. And I mean, I am constantly getting messages. We have the Wheel of Fortune, Alchemical Force, and the Magician right off the bat. Okay? Seriously. Devastation, Five of Swords, Knight of Wands. I mean, it is Wisdom, the Star, Eight of Wands. There's just so much here. There's so much to be seen. There's so much to be heard. If you just open your eyes and open your ears and listen, it is incredible. We have Wisdom, Righteousness, Healing, Darkness, Protection, Completeness, Being Ordinary, Hermitage. I haven't even looked that one up. I don't know what that means. Resourcefulness, Hope, Union and Power. I mean, it's all over the place. Truth and Fairness. You have Light, you have Dark, you have everything in between. Intelligence, Skill. This is a deck that I did not expect. I didn't expect it. I knew it was going to be good. I mean, it's an Egyptian deck. I knew that I was going to find a use for it. I just didn't expect the use that I found for it. And I just love little happy surprises like that. I truly, truly do. It has blown my mind and made me so happy just to be able to have this change, justice, passion, skill, enlightening. Of course, that one is raw. Transformation, meditation, faith and wisdom, death and rebirth, prosperity, understanding, order and peace, creation, fruitfulness. I mean, there are only 36 cards in here, and I do hope that they like have, I know that there are enough gods and goddesses where they could go and do a whole series of these, but even just however they were however they choose to do it, as long as they keep it the same size and everything so it can be shuffled in together, I would love to see another one of these. But even with just the 36 cards, I feel like there's enough here to work with whatever deck you choose, for it to not feel small. Like, it doesn't feel small. It feels anything but small. There's just something about it. It speaks to me in a way that none of my oracles have so far. And I hope that somehow or another you have seen this and maybe it can speak to you in the same way. And check out the links below that I'm going to post for the Law of One if you have never heard of that. Or at least Google it, check it out for yourself if you don't want to sit long. There are long videos, some of them, not all of them, but if you're actually going to listen to the books, yeah, they're long. But, you know, check it out, give it a shot, and just remember that we are all one. Let there be no division. And thanks for liking, thanks for subscribing, and thanks for hanging out with me. I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.